We know from the archives that a farmer was trying to plant a tree in the 1890s, and then above us, and he found some masonry. Since he really wanted to plant that tree, he tried to blow it off with some dynamite. But it happens all the time. There are ancient ruins everywhere. Just again, if you don't care and there's nobody interested, the discovery really hasn't happened. And so people knew about this, and they went on up until 1932. They didn't do much. But looking at how big it was, and they thought that the volcanic field that you see was the one that buried Pompeii, etc., they thought maybe this could be the villa where Augustus died. We were under fascism. Mussolini was using the figure of Augustus. And he was actually setting up the exhibition in remembrance of the bimillenary of the birth of Augustus. The local mayor, was called back then Podestà, sent a letter to Mussolini. Please, Duce, Dux, give us the money. Sadly, the letter never reached Mussolini.
Italian style.
And so nothing happened up until then. My father was in a dinner with some American professors. My father was upset with all the politics in Pompeii and Herculaneum. He said, why don't we start something new on the other side?
Absolutely incredible. What's on this kind of archway here?
This is just the entrance to the huge villa. We have uncovered a lot of archaeological artifacts here and beautiful architecture, but it's just the entrance. So from this point on, this should be the proper Roman villa. Also gives the key to understand the entire building. All symbols which directly or indirectly connect to Dionysus. Clusters of grapes and vines and a couple of clusters of grapes here in between the columns. The basket used for the rites of Dionysus. The message was trying to exploit, again, the main business, the core business of the area, which was the wine production. So in the sign of Dionysus, which was the god born twice, we can have this land reborn again. Socially speaking, they also gave power to the women to get out of the big social construct that the Greek and Roman society had it. So through the cult of Dionysus, they could express themselves. Quite interestingly, there was the statue of the god here in the main room of the entrance. And then following the pipes, we can reach the wine cellar. These channels that go really under your feet and then bring the juice right to the Dolia. By multiplying what we have by four, we have the largest wine facility ever discovered. Some people talk about orgies, what are they doing? And they were concerned about this, and they banned the cult of Dionysus all over the empire. But people sometimes don't get that this overwhelming presence of Dionysus in Pompeii is because it was the core business of the region, and the wine produced around Vesuvius was literally brought to all the western part of the empire through the amphora. You see the clay, you see the inclusions from Vesuvius. You can really tell where they come from. So we know where the containers went, where they came from. The wine produced around Vesuvius was brought to Gaul, Spain, but went up to Hadrian's Wall, what later will become Hadrian's Wall, so all up in Britain,
in England,
but also Egypt, through Egypt to India.
Yeah.
We have amphora produced in Pompeii to India. I don't know what kind of wine could have come there for such long distance. Where in Italy there's the biggest cult of Dionysus in Puglia and in Campania. Mm-hmm. We have the Taranta and we have the Tamorra here. But they are basically the same. So here you can see that's the easiest to spot is the flute of Pan. Mm-hmm. To the right, it's just the imprint of an ellipse. And I think it's probably the tambourine of a man. Here as well, we have the same kind of decoration there on top. There's this sort of pavilion decoration. There's a phallus covered by a veil. So there's again, and speculatively repeated there, the key of the rites of the ancestors. The main business of the villa, as I said, was wine production. Everything started in the sign of Dionysus because of the wine production. And so at some point, they decided to change the use of these former rooms, very rich, and make it the wine production very close even to those rooms. So even from here, you can see the wine cellar. And these are what we call Doria.
Venite giù.
Okay.
Portate le amfore
2000 anni fa.
And that's where at the beginning they start crushing with their feet, chanting the songs of Dionysus. And then they put what remains of the wineskins and with the pips, etc., under the presses. And so from then they try to get every drop of juice.
Quindi questo era un processo che poi era anche molto spettacolarizzato, perché poi pressavano lì sotto la statua di Dioniso, poi mettevano nelle presse e poi il succo arrivava direttamente in Edolia.
The grapes which are in this region are typical of this region for as much as we can go back, which means almost toward the beginning of the Middle Ages. There's no way that there's been a huge change with grapes coming from other areas before, so it's likely that what we are drinking today is really the same grapes that existed in antiquity.
Tu vedi un affresco o un vaso, dici, ah, c'è un uccello, ma no, c'è una pianta, no. Hanno sempre un senso, in antichità avevano un senso. Quindi dire una pianta se è una quercia o un alloro, o un uccello se è una gazza o un passero, ha un valore completamente diverso.
Certo.
Allo stesso modo c'era anche un rapporto diverso con la natura. Anche i grappoli non sono di fantasia, sono in base a quelli che venivano usati qua.
Quante volte sei stato qui?
È la prima volta. Cioè, la prima volta che con il prof scendo nelle Anfo. Non ci siamo mai permessi, quindi siete... Veramente oggi è stata una giornata dell'esclusività. Yes.
The idea was to create something unique that doesn't exist.
Also, I asked him to risk a bit when, with the discussion I was having with Ciro, somehow that there was something that was blocking a bit the wine, based on the fact that Catalanesca and especially that soil is going to be in high pH, so it's not easy, you know, going towards, you know, more or less on the natural wine path without crossing that border. That is the idea.
Guarda questo vino, non è mai stato mosso da quest'anfora.
Pazzesco.
E guarda la pulizia che ha, olfattiva,
sì, sì, però.
Olfattiva e gustativa.
Mai chiaro, non caso, mai filtrato.
Niente.
Niente.
Cioè questa è uva schiacciata. Noi non ci abbiamo fatto nulla. Al Vesuvio Roscione.
What an incredible day.
Grazie.
Guarda, io...
Grazie.
Io voglio farvi...